An AI just saved me more than 100 hours of work by turning this into this. Hi everyone. If you're an academic, a lecturer, or even a student who takes a lot of notes, you will know that one of the most time-consuming tasks we face is creating high-quality teaching material. For every hour I spend up here delivering a lecture, there are countless more hours spent preparing. And after the lecture is done, there is the task of creating comprehensive handouts or notes so that students can revise the material properly. It involves transcribing, formatting, drawing diagrams. Frankly, it's a monumental effort. But what if we could automate a good portion of it? Today I want to show you an experiment I ran that I believe is a game changer for academic productivity. I took the raw, automatically generated captions from my recorded lectures and fed them into a large language model. The results were, and I don't use this word lightly, astonishing. Before delving into the video, I want to make a disclaimer. In the discourse around AI, I have noticed the formation of two factions. Those who are extremely positive about AI, they state that AI is going to make us more productive in our work, it is going to make students learn better, and it is in general going to be a positive force for society. Moreover, these people state that AI's capabilities are superior to peak human, or close to be superior, with some talking, for instance, of AI which have an intelligence, whatever that means, comparable to that of a PhD student. Instead, on the other side of the fence, we have people who are strong AI skeptics. These people point out the errors and mistakes that AI make, which often are trivial. Some others believe that AI is going to create large unemployment, as AI will replace workers. Some believe that the use of AI will be damaging for students, as they will delegate their need for critical thinking. Some point at the ethical issues around AI, the copyright implications, its climate change impact, and so on. I want to clarify that I do not belong to either of these groups. AI has advantages and disadvantages. AI is a tool that can be used effectively for certain tasks, but is not a magic bullet that solves everything. In this video, I will stress the incredible performance of the AI in the task of creating teaching material, but the output of the AI is not perfect, and the produced material cannot be used without an expert revision. So let's dive in. Last year, I started to teach a new course, Control Engineering, in the third year of the MEng at Imperial College London. The previous lecturer, Professor Astolfi, kindly provided me with his handouts so that I didn't have to start from scratch. However, for my lectures, I wanted to create my own version of what I wanted to teach. So before each lecture, I would handwrite some notes, which I would then project in class to comment on it. A drawback of this approach is that I did not have proper typed handouts based on my own lectures. Students needed to rely on my handwritten bare notes, their own notes, and the typed handouts of the previous lecturer, which did not fully match my lectures. Why didn't I type the notes? Well, because it takes a huge amount of time, and the first year running a course, there is a lot of other things going on. So typing the notes is something that is often left for the following years. How much time does it take? I would estimate about 5 hours for each hour of lecture. So we're talking of hundreds of hours of work. Now, recently I made a video where I challenged AIs into solving the homework I give to students. The question I had was whether a student can get a top mark in an engineering homework without even reading the homework. If you're curious, you can watch that video by clicking over here. Anyway, the point is that by playing around with AIs for that video, I got a good feeling of their capabilities, and so I had an idea. What if I take the automatically generated transcript of my lecture recordings and I fed it into a large language model, an AI? Would the AI be able to generate handouts out of it? And what would be the quality, considering even my very bad accent? So this is the starting point. Most universities now use lecture capture systems like Panopto. They provide a auto transcription, which is helpful for accessibility, but in reality, the captions are of very low quality, essentially a mess. For instance, let's look at this example. And for a year or two, these students promoted the year one class students and not promoted the two year three. As you can see, it is barely coherent. To turn this into a set of notes would require abilities that are close to superhuman. Think about it. The transcript is grammatically broken. Some words are incorrect. Moreover, even if the transcript were correct, I do not explain everything in the transcript. The main information is in the visual part of the recording. Students attending the lecture or watching the recording can see and read the questions and diagrams, which I am not reading out loud. I'm just explaining some aspect of it. So being able to construct high quality handouts from the transcript will be something short of a miracle. Let's try and see. So here is what I did. I copied the entire transcript of a lecture and gave it to a large language model. Of course, the most important part of this is to create a good prompt. You have to tell the AI not just what to do, but how to think. So let's look at the prompt. I read it now. I'm going to provide you with a transcript of a lecture on control engineering. I want that you turn this transcript into complete and detailed lecture notes. You need to interpret the transcript, infer the context, and fill in the mathematical details. Expand on the content as you see fit in order to improve clarity and rigor. Be as detailed, precise, and complete as possible. Only generate your output in LaTeX. The key phrases here are infer the context, fill in with mathematical details, and improve clarity and rigor. I'm not asking the AI to be a simple transcriber. I'm asking it to be a co-author, an expert assistant who understands the subject matter. And of course, the instruction to output directly to LaTeX is crucial. LaTeX, if you do not know, is a professional typesetting language for scientific writing. For this experiment, I used the Gemini 2.5 Pro, available through Google AI Studio. This is one of the most powerful models currently available, and I used about 300,000 tokens for this task, which is above the limit of some other models. Let's look at our first example. In my lecture, I was introducing a simple discrete time model for student population dynamics in a 3-year degree, a model that I took from the handouts of Professor Astolfi. Let's look first at the automatically generated transcript of my speech, part of it. We can say that the number of students in year one at the next step is going to be equal to the sum of the intake plus the students that are not promoted. Now, this part is understandable, but let's look at the second part. And for a year or two, these students promoted year one class students and not promoted the 2 year three. So you have to be the same. Okay. And the output is going to be simply they promoted the students at your team. This is a jumble, a complete mess, which doesn't make any sense. Now watch what the AI produced from that. The result is astonishing. It correctly identified the state variables, the inputs, the outputs. It inferred the meaning of promotion rates and failure rates. And most impressively, it assembled the entire system into the standard state space matrix form, complete with correctly labeled A, B, C, and D matrices. This is not just a transcription. This is synthesis. It took a conceptual verbal description, a bad one, and translated it into rigorous mathematical language. The time saved here is already immense, but it gets even better. What happens when I discuss a more abstract and difficult concept? In the next lecture, I talked about the conditions for the existence and uniqueness of solutions of differential equations, a tricky topic. So let's look at the transcript. And the idea that we proposed was okay, then maybe if we block that variation, if we say that variation cannot be very fast, maybe this solves the problem. We are saying that the derivative has to be bounded. It means that the function has to be under a certain line, has to be bounded by a line. It cannot grow faster than a line. Okay. Again, conceptually correct, but far from a formal definition and definitely very difficult to parse. Remember that I was relying on the whiteboard so students could see what I was referring to. The AI took this and built a complete textbook quality explanation. Look at this. It introduced the formal concept of Lipschitz continuity. He provided the precise mathematical formulation by recalling the definition of vector norms. It even mentioned the Picard-Lindelof theorem, which is the fundamental result that I was alluding to, but I didn't name. It even inferred that when I mentioned a line, I was referring about a linear bound, and he created a diagram using ticks, in LaTeX, to illustrate why a certain equation fails the Lipschitz condition. Now, the power of this is undeniable. It saved me a lot of work, and the quality of the notes is exceptional. It's not perfect, but it's close to perfect. Maybe 95% perfect. But this capability also raises some profound ethical questions we need to address. Think about this. Lectures are the intellectual property of the lecturer and of the university, developed over years of work. What if a company took the publicly available recordings of a famous professor, ran them through this process, and published, for a fee, a textbook without the professor's involvement or consent? Who is the author? Is it the professor who gave the lecture? Is it the AI? Is it the company that ran the process? Current copyright law is not equipped to handle this. Is the RO transcript transformative enough? Well, probably not. But is it a fully fledged textbook, complete with new diagrams and formal definitions, a new work? It's a legal and ethical minefield. It also changes the nature of academic work. If creating materials becomes this easy, where does the value lie? It shifts the focus, correctly in my opinion, back to the act of teaching, mentoring, and inspiring. These are important questions that we need to have now, before the technology outpaces our ethical frameworks. We are clearly at the dawn of a new era in how we create and share knowledge. I believe that tools like these aren't here to replace universities, but to augment us, to free us from tedious work and allow us to operate at a higher level. For students, this means faster access to higher quality, more detailed learning material. For educators, it means more time to teach and do research. It's a win-win. I'm incredibly excited to see how these tools will evolve. But what are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments below, give a like and subscribe, and see you next time.